Hello everyone and welcome to another video by Centipede Geek. Today I have a movie news vlog for you guys where I talk about all the latest in movie news, television news. I have even had a little bit of book news. And then one of my most important articles and probably my most sad and depressing articles today about a recent famous actor that died. And if you're into this kind of stuff, you probably already know, though I won't talk about that news story until later on. This is for the day of February 2nd of the year 2014. I know I just made a video about movie news a week or so back, but I wanted to do one at least one every week. That way you guys know what's going on in the movie news world. So without any further ado, let's go and get to it, shall we? If you guys are a fan of the SNL, or otherwise known as Saturday Night Live, Seth Meyers made his last appearance on the show just last night. The host was Melissa McCarthy. It was a great episode, and that was his last time being on the show. He will now move to the NBC show, his own talk show on the channel of NBC, and I believe it comes out sometime in mid-February, the 17th or 20th or somewhere around that timeline. If you Google it, you can find out. Just so you guys also know, a link to all these articles will be in the description bar below. I get my news from IMDb, Daily Dead, horrormovies.ca, Beyond Hollywood, Rotten Tomatoes, along with a few other sites. And you can find links to those sites in the description bar below if you want to read the full article for yourself. If you're into books and if you're a fan of Stephen King and other news, a plot description is available for his new book titled Revival, which I believe will be coming out later on this year, though I don't know an exact release date yet. I'm not going to read the entire article, but if you want to know a plot description, you can click that link below and it'll take you straight to where you can read that. Other news, I'm kind of jumping through this stuff fast because I have a lot of stuff to talk about. We have more casting news on the miniseries that will air on NBC by the name of Rosemary's Baby, based off the original film from the year of 1958 or 68, somewhere around then. And the new actors, or people by the name of Christina Cole and Carol Bouquet, and they join the already announced actors by the name of Patrick J. Adams, Jason Isaacs, and Zoe Saldana. And that's pretty much rounding out the main cast of that new miniseries. And other news, we now have a new promo for the Hannibal Season 2 that will come out right after the Winter Olympics airs, later on in the month of February. There is some new casting news also. There is a character, an actor by the name of Michael Pitt, and from what I understand, he will play the character that Gary Oldman played in some of the original Hannibal films. So if you remember that character, Michael Pitt's not going to play that character. His character won't be introduced, though, till later on. And then they have a plan to extend his role, the character of Mason Verger's story, across multiple seasons. Once again, click that link to that website for the full info on that. Apparently, I just found out this news just a few minutes ago, so I don't know too much about it, but apparently there is a miniseries by the name of Mars Attacks Firstborn announced and in the works. So if you want to know more on that, go ahead and click that. I guess there was some sort of little comic or something that was, and that's where they are pulling this miniseries from, and apparently it was a 4-issue series, and now they want to turn that comic into a little miniseries. So that's pretty cool. I love the original Mars Attacks film, so it's going to be really cool seeing that being adapted. And other news, this was announced a while back, but it's now just now coming into play. Neil Marshall will direct the Constantine TV series pilot that will air on the channel NBC, and from what I understand, they want to have it done by this fall so they can air it in their fall TV block. Now, the Constantine television series pilot was announced a while ago, but it's just now coming into play where we have a director announced. Neil Marshall has directed a few films in the name of The Descent and Doomsday. So if you're curious about that, go ahead and check that out. Other news, we now have new release dates for Guillermo del Toro, and if you don't know him, Hellboy, Pan's Labyrinth, recently Pacific Rim, the director. New release date for his film in the name of film in the name of Crimson Peak. Crimson Peak will come out October 16th of the year of 2015, And it stars actors and actresses by the name of Mia Wasikowska, Jessica Chastain, Tom Hiddleston, and Charlie Hunnam. And that rounds out the main cast. It says, in the aftermath of a family tragedy, an aspiring author is torn between love for her childhood friend and the temptation of a mysterious outsider. Trying to escape the ghost of her past, she is swept away to a house that breathes, bleeds, and remembers. And that's pretty much the main plot synopsis. Other news, if you're into the CW channel, they just announced that they are getting a new television series by the name of I, Zombie. And it just got its pilot order. It's sort of like a cop drama where we have a zombie, and this zombie has a craving for brains, and it ends up getting a job at an autopsy, so it's a sort of a zombie with a personality. And once it eats a person, it acquires that person's memories, which allows and acquires them to help, you know, solve crimes and murders and stuff like that. So it's sort of a cop drama. Sort of an interesting premise, I thought. That's called iZombie on the CW channel. And other news. There is a brand new trailer. There was already a little teaser trailer that was announced, but this is a full-on length trailer for the TV series on the El Rey Network by the name From Dusk Till Dawn, the series, originally based off Robert Rodriguez's film. And it will come out March 11th of this year, and the trailer looks downright awesome. I love the trailer. It's going to have, I believe, roughly 10 episodes, I believe, and it looks awesome. I can't wait to see, you know, where the series is going to go and just how it's going to work and how it's going to play into the original film and the vampires. It's going to be really cool stuff. I love the original film. So then we have other news. I also just found out about this, so I don't know too much about it, so I may not have much to say. But if you're a fan of Clive Barker, I guess he's been working on some, you know, some short stories, or he's had these in the works for a while. They're not in the works. They've been released for a while, excuse me. By the name of Books of Blood, these books have been out for years, and I guess just recently some people acquired some film rights to one of those Books of Blood by the name of Jacqueline S. Herwill and Testament. And since the film rights were just acquired for those, that means in the next 3 or 4 years, or maybe even sooner, we could see a film adaptation of that one. Once again, that title is Jacqueline S. Herwill and Testament. And that's a Clive Barker Book of Blood short story that was released several years ago. If you're a fan of the Haven sci-fi television series, don't worry. It was recently just confirmed for a fifth season that will consist of a whopping total of 26 episodes. That's a huge season. Never seen a season with that many episodes. Anyways, I don't watch the series, but I've always been kind of curious. I know it's on Netflix. But if you're a fan, fifth season will air, I guess, sometime next year. If you're a fan of Doctor Who, Peter Capaldi obviously playing the new Doctor Who, you know, succeeding the role of Matt Smith, and his sort of suit or costume has just recently been revealed. So if you want to see a picture of that, click that link below. And here is probably our most depressing and loss article. A famous actor died just recently, just today, about a few hours ago. The news was released on the website by the name of imdb.com, Internet Movie Database. And this is a very sad article. I'll probably spend a few minutes on this to reflect on this. And I may even have to split this video up into a few parts, because I would like to spend a few extra moments on this particular article, since it is some very sad news. An actor by the name of Phillip Seymour Hoffman was recently found dead in his New York apartment. That while there are no official news yet on the details of his death, law enforcement officials are saying that they found a needle in his arm, and they're suspecting that it was a drug overdose, though nothing is official yet. And as more news comes in, I'll probably release a few more videos, that way I can let you guys know what is going on. Now, obviously, Philip Seymour Hoffman is a very famous actor. He's been in several films. I've seen him in things such as Patch Adams. Recently, I really enjoyed him in that. I believe he was also in The Master not too long ago, you know, a year or two ago. And recently, he was in The Hunger Games Catching Fire, The Hunger Games sequel. And he was working on the Hunger Games sequels, both Mockingjay Part 1 and Mockingjay Part 2. Now, I'm not for sure exactly what they are going to do with his role. I'm not for sure how much, if they've started shooting or how many scenes they have shot, or if they've even started shooting yet. So I'm not for sure if they're going to use his footage or replace him or what they're going to do. They'll probably end up having to replace him. But it's very sad news because I was really starting to, when I saw Hunger Games Catching Fire, I was really starting to enjoy Philip Seymour Hoffman as an actor. And it was just, you know, really sad news that I